Yes, it is very regrettable that when we are trying to push for this better society, we envisage the state which is really supposed to enable the realization of this vision is an enemy of that particular vision. It has adopted a mechanism of using violence as a solution to everything. So they use violence to try to silence us when we demand salaries. We don't know what they seek to project. For example, I've been abducted twice this year and been severely tortured by my own state for simply demanding a living wage for the teachers. I've been arrested 6 times from January to date, and I've been taken to court for simply demanding a living wage for the teachers. I've been thrown in maximum prison for 16 days. I've been also, the second time this year, again, I was thrown in maximum prison for 5 days. The charges remain the same, that I'm pushing for a living wage. Of course, they will come up with some funny charges. I'm standing in trial today for 2 cases right now. One, for subverting a constitutionally elected government. How did I subvert a constitutionally elected government? Because I organized for a protest by teachers against fuel prices, against the low salaries, and then this amounts to subversion in their own terms. So treason, it's treasonous to be asking for a meal, it's treasonous to be asking for health care, it's treasonous to be asking for a better working and living condition as a worker. The second charge that I'm facing right now is criminal nuisance. And I don't know how that kind of behavior is called nuisance in doubt, that that becomes criminal. Where we go to the finance minister's office, just picket demanding a living wage on the 23rd of August this year, at what we call the payday funeral, where there we humbly took a coffin and as a group went to mourn our salaries at the office of the finance minister. That is not nuisance, because really we are hungry, and up to now we are hungry. We are mourning the death of our salaries because our salaries could provide a living for us. That was our source of livelihood. We don't have anything else to sell other than our labor. And if we sell it and we don't get paid, how are we supposed to take care of ourselves? So we have had 7 abductions of our members this year. We have over 55 cases of teachers who have been visited at their workplace by members of the state agent, the Central Intelligence Organization. They were harassed in front of their learners. Why? Because they just belong to Amalgamated Rothschilds Union of Zimbabwe. So the state is criminalizing the existence of that particular union. The state is deliberately trying to decimate the organization through harassing our membership, through arresting our members, through even seizing our salaries. I will tell you that I last received a salary in January this year, but I've been working. So they threw me in remand. They threw me in prison for 16 days. When I was released from prison, my salary had been seized. They say I was absent for more than 14 days. But that really doesn't work, because I was in prison. It's like seizing someone's salary because he's in hospital, and I'm still to be convicted. This was remand prison. And I'm remand prison, you seize my salary. Then we are trying to push for the activation of the same salary. So they tell you that we are processing the salary from January to date. They will say there are a lot of administrative hiccups, but we are working on them. But my family left to survive now. So they did not do this to me alone. They did it to our Secretary General also. They did it to our members. They had some part of their salaries deducted because they belong to our union and participated in our union activities. So we have a really barbaric state which is employing all some of the most barbaric tactics to try to silence genuine grievances coming from a legitimate teacher grouping, wherein we don't have any other intentions other than seeking the improvement of our working and living conditions. But all the same, really, they've also tried to criminalize our participation in national questions. But we can, as workers, really, our problems are not isolated from the national question. We have every right to organize people to vote. We have every right to ensure that our members vote. We have every right to ensure that we bring civic consciousness to our societies, because we are also so citizens before we are teachers. And they cannot criminalize our participation in our civic responsibilities and duties. So this is very unfortunate that they've chosen that route. We have had a time when some of our comrades had to flee from the country, running away from their own government, leaving their workplace. We have up to up to now, for the 100, now there are 201 teachers who have resigned from beginning of September to date. For some are resigning because they are earning less. But some are even resigning because they are afraid to work in the communities where they work in. Where ordinarily, if it's a rural area, we have people, the ZANU-PF party, using coercion as a tool of retaining power. So they are harassing anyone and everyone. And those who are teachers are targeted more because they are said to be opinion leaders. So these are some of the unfortunate instances that we have to deal with. The level of repression which we have to handle is unacceptable, especially in a republic where people claim to be democratic, and worse off, a government which calls itself a new dispensation, claiming to be a new. So we ordinarily expected a paradigm shift, but we expect the worst. You realize the worst.